Do you think the world right now is going from bad to worse? Do you feel scared about the future of this world? Well, you're not alone, all of us do this. But the thing is, people living thousands of years before us did the same thing. The best way for us to understand what is really going on in this world is to read history. Now I know, a lot of people run away when they hear the word history, but that's because of the way it's taught in schools. There isn't any point in memorizing dates and names, but it is extremely important for us to know why people did the things they did. What were the ideas that motivated them? Ideas are the most important lessons from history, because after all, the gun itself was once an idea that changed war forever, and democracy itself was once a radical idea that has shaped our lives forever. Hey guys, welcome back to Inside Junkie, and today we are talking about Will and Ariel Durant's book, Lessons of History. Will Durant and his wife Ariel were both Pulitzer Prize winning historians who had documented history in 11 books called The Story of Civilization, and in this book called The Lessons of History, they have given us the main lessons that they could gather from 2,500 years of history around the world. Now before starting, I'll state what Will stated in the book, which is that it is extremely difficult to condense so many years of history into one small book with lessons. And on top of that, I'm doing this in the form of a video. So this is by no means a comprehensive guide to history. Like Will says, history is mostly just guessing and the rest is prejudice. In spite of that, we try to learn whatever we can from wherever we can. So we still proceed, and in this video I will give you 5 lessons from history. Now number 1 is biology. When we look at other animals, we try to observe their behavior in different situations. And when we analyze ourselves too, we can quite clearly see that our biology has a huge role to play in the way we live our lives. Our basic needs to eat, sleep and reproduce still run a major part of our lives. The first major lesson that Will Durant gives us about biology is that life itself is competition. Even though we may not like it, we are always competing with other people for resources. We compete for jobs with other people, we compete with each other to attract mates and make ourselves more attractive. Competition is simply ingrained in our DNA. Although humans do cooperate, even when we do, most of the times it's because we're simply competing with another group. Employees working in a company may cooperate with each other to finish a project, but they're also competing as a whole against another company. Even in war, when soldiers cooperate with each other to protect their country, they're also competing against another country. So naturally, when there is competition, there will be some losers and some winners. This is called survival of the fittest. It is not possible for everyone to be winners. That is why Will Durant says that freedom and equality cannot exist together in perfect harmony. Now this might be hard to understand, so I'll give you a simple example. Let's say our society was 100% free, meaning that there were no laws. This would mean that the strongest and most powerful men who could fight anyone would rule over everyone else who was weaker than them. This would technically be a free society where you could do whatever you want, but it would also be very unequal because a man who is tall and muscular could rule over everyone. In the same way, if you were all 100% equal, then there would be very less freedom because you cannot rise above everyone else. This would be kind of a communist, non-capitalist state, and this would lead to no innovation. So the best we can hope for is to find the right balance between freedom and equality, achieve a certain degree of freedom and a certain degree of equality so we can live peacefully while still getting the chance to compete. The second point is religion. Now this can be a triggering topic for some people, but if you keep an open mind, you'll probably get this. According to Will Durant, even if you're the most skeptical atheist who doesn't believe in God, you still have to acknowledge that religion plays an important role in organizing a society. Us humans like to be in groups, we want to believe in something, and religion fulfills that basic human need. Religion is what gives people hope, and according to Napoleon Bonaparte, religion is what keeps the poor from murdering the rich. While I don't think it's that extreme, I do acknowledge the importance of religion in our society. Now, Will asks a very important question. Does history prove the existence of God? Well, he says that if we look at the amount of human suffering alone, the answer is a resounding no. But that doesn't disprove that there isn't a God. Here's all Will says about history. All civilizations go through periods of increasing religiousness followed by increasing irreligiousness. This has been the case throughout all civilizations. In the beginning, the people are very religious, but slowly, as they learn more about science and technology, the faith throughout the generations starts to shrink a little bit. But then eventually, society starts to crave that order and discipline again. And then according to Will, there comes a time when even atheists start sending their children to church just so they can learn to be more disciplined. Will also says one important thing. There has been no time in recorded history where any society has been able to sustain moral order without religion. Now, I don't know if I agree or disagree with Will Durant because I think this is a matter of opinion, but it is true that we haven't had a society so far where religion did not exist. Maybe we achieve some sort of new feat where we do this in the near future, but according to history, it doesn't look like it will be possible anytime soon. The next point is economics. It has been seen throughout history that money does seem to be a key motivator for people to be productive. Forced slave labor isn't actually that productive because as it turns out, people in a free market are much more motivated to work to make their lives better. Now, in the kind of economic system we have nowadays in most part of the world, which is mostly capitalistic, according to Will Durant, it's only natural that wealth would accumulate only within a few sections of society. I know we all like to complain about the 1%, but according to Will, this has happened all throughout history. The more skilled, lucky, and privileged people start to amass more wealth, and the more money they have, the more money they can make. However, an extreme difference between the rich and the poor is also not good, because throughout history, this has caused massive revolutions. So Will says that basically economics of the world works in a cycle. There is a period of concentration of wealth towards the rich, and then there is a redistribution of wealth to the poor, either through violent revolutions or peacefully through other ways like progressive taxation. Now the next point is about war. If there's one thing that we can learn from history is that war is very common. In fact, less than 10% of recorded history has ever been peaceful. So as you can see, it is in fact peace that is not normal. Now there are some generals throughout history who have argued that war is actually a good thing. And looking at it a certain way, they're not entirely wrong. They say that war creates tough people and tough people are able to protect their country more. Now obviously, I think all of us can agree that war is something that should be avoided. But according to Will Durant, history is very clear about this. World peace has never been achieved before. So I hope that we can achieve it at some point and we can do away with war entirely. History, unfortunately, is not on our side. And the last point is progress. And this is a very important point. As you've seen throughout this video, it seems like everything in history follows a cycle. Something is good for us, but it's also bad for us. It seems like we're taking one step forward and one step backward. Technology makes our life easier, but it also makes us lazy. The world is more connected, but we're also more scared every day because of the news. So are we making any real progress? Well, it depends on what we call progress. In the book, they define progress as increasing our control over our environment, and by that standard, we are making a lot of progress. We are now more in control of our health, our surroundings, our families than ever before in history. The most important thing I got from this book is that the only way we humans can move forward is to try to avoid mistakes that we made in history. I believe that all education systems around the world should emphasize these ideas more than just the mere facts of history, because these ideas are what can actually prevent us from making mistakes in the future. So in summary, in this video, I told you about what history has to say about biology, religion, economics, war, and progress. I'll put a link in the description below if you want to read this book for yourself. And I seriously recommend that you do this because it's very fascinating to see what history has to say about different topics like education, religion, etc. I hope this video taught you something new, and if it did, then please click the like button, subscribe and click the bell icon so you don't miss any future videos. And thanks for watching.